No.
Start over.
What was, am I supposed to say?
That's a good one.
Hi, I'm Jordan, and welcome back to Eagle TV. I'm with my co-anchor, Brooke.
Hey, guys. Yeah, there's a lot of new things to look forward to this time. We actually have a new segment done by Adrian called Texas Trivia, so that's something to look forward to.
And we also are implementing co-anchors, so from now on in all the shows, we will be hosting the show. Let's get into it.
Oh.
Hold on. No. Okay, just roll the clip.
Start it.
Why did the banker push over her client?
I don't know.
She asked her to check her balance. Why did the banker push over her client?
Why?
Because she asked her to check her balance.
Welcome back to Let's Review Season 2. Today we'll be reviewing a game that I've been playing, honestly, like probably too much recently, and that's Mario Kart 8 / Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, really just depends on what kind of, you know, system you have. For me, Mario Kart 8 has always been a kind of like mix between simple and complex. It's more simple in that the fact it feels more arcade-like than, you know, more like games like Forza Horizon or Motorsport or like the Gran Turismo series. But it has the complex system of the items as well, which just adds another layer to the game. And I like that how it like kind of incorporates like all the kind of vehicles you kind of see throughout Mario and comes up with new concepts on its own as well. I also like the inclusion of Link from Legend of Zelda. He's honestly one of my favorite characters in the game. And really just the customization of your stats and everything, how you can make it go better, just really adds that kind of extra layer of like simplicity, but also like being complex at the same time. Really, that's just the thing it does the best. So I give Mario Kart 8 an 8 out of 10, but I give the Deluxe Edition a 9 out of 10 because I feel it added better customization and kind of tweaked some issues that Mario Kart 8 original kind of had. And on that note, this has been Let's Review. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.
Hi, I'm Jordan, and welcome back to Daily Dose of Davis. Did you know that humans are the only animals that actually enjoy spicy food, and humans are the only animals whose brains can shrink? That is crazy. That's all for this week. Come back next week for more Dazzle. Bye.
Hi, welcome back to Hacks with Hughes, and as usual, I'm Adrian Hughes. So let's get right to it. Our first hack is useful for those who utilize YouTube as a source for listening to music. So instead of staying on the app the whole time, you can click the two A's on the left corner and click Request Desktop Site. Now, when you go to your like lock screen, it will still show as though the music is not playing. Just click play like as it would normally pop up, and you should be able to listen to the music. Our next hack is useful for those who have a lot of frizz in their hair. So try going to bed with a satin or silk scarf or pillowcase. This will prevent your hair from just undergoing all that extra frizz it does at night. And our last hack is for those who just lose things, myself included. So next time you play something that's really important down, verbally, out loud, tell yourself that you're placing, like, I'm putting my phone on the dresser, and that will just help you remember where you left it. That's all the hacks for today. Goodbye.
So Brooke, why do they tell people to break a leg before they go on stage?
I don't know.
Because every good show needs a cast.
Oh my gosh, that's so bad.
All right, next up on our segment, we have Summer with Summer State, so enjoy.
Hi, and welcome back to Summer States. Today we'll be in the great state of Iowa, so let's go. Did you know that pigs outnumber human population in Iowa to about a 7-to-1 ratio? I wonder how many pigs they have. Also, did you know that Iowa has the third highest motorcycle ownership in the nation? Well, that's all for this segment, and thanks for watching. Bye.
Welcome back to King of the Hill. For today's matchup, we have the most probably classic video game rivalry there is, and that's Mario versus Sonic. I know, the whole Nintendo, Sega, funny, the Italian plumber and the blue hedgehog, yeah, we all know them. I think this could be interesting because you have to factor in Sonic's incredible speed as well as his, you know, super and hyper forms, which give him like massive indestructibility, but you also have to count in all the stuff from Mario with things like the Fire Flower and the Star Mode and the... It's just a battle with a lot of variables, and that's what makes it interesting, and also that it has a lot of legend behind it. I don't think it's fair to use the Archie Sonic, but the Archie Sonic is just... Archie Sonic, we don't talk about him. He is a special case, well, to say the least. But I do think that it would be interesting to see stuff like that, especially since these characters have had so many different iterations that you can kind of just... You would have to pick a continuity, I guess. I don't know. Just what do you want to include, what do you don't? And that's what kind of gives this a flair almost, but also keeps that element of retro in it because these guys have been around for a long time. But that's why I think it's a good matchup. Let me know who you think would win in the comments below and make sure that you drop any possible matchups in the future. And I'll see you next time.
Welcome to a new segment called Texas Trivia, where I ask ACA members questions about Texas to see if they're Texas worthy. All right, so our first question is, when did Texas join the United States?
Sometime in the 1800s.
That is actually really close.
It's 1845. All right. So when did Texas join the United States? 1845, 1900s, or 1920?
1845.
Yeah, okay. All right, so what's your name?
Jonah Panter.
All right, Jonah. So, do you know what the capital of Texas is?
T.
Okay, good job. Thank you.
Well, that's a wrap for this week. Make sure you come back next week and be sure you like and subscribe. Let's see if we can do it this time. Yes, we did it. Bye, guys.